In the ring right now, State Representative Mike Brady is presenting a document from the Massachusetts House of Representatives to Captain Anthony Palermo's families from Brockton, Massachusetts.
This is signed by the Speaker of the House, Robert DeLeo, and myself, State Rep. Mike Brady. Thank you, Mike. Congratulations.
And a nice ovation from the crowd from that presentation from Mike Brady to the family of Captain Anthony Palermo from Brockton.
I'd like to turn the microphone for a moment over to Rich Bergeron, who's going to give a little word on the fallen runner.
And Edwin, you are going to stick with us for the next fight. Right now, we'll put the headsets down as Rich Bergeron has a special presentation.
One of my duties here this evening is to bring you the following tribute to fallen service. Please be as quiet as possible during this, because it's some very important remarks. Please keep the noise to a minimum. First, I want to speak directly about my personal friend and fellow amateur boxer, Captain Anthony Palermo Jr. of Brockton, Massachusetts. Anthony was killed Friday, April 6, 2007, in a bomb blast in Baghdad, Iraq, caused by an IED. Everyone in his vehicle perished. His son, Tony, never got to see come into this world, was born just a few weeks later. Tony was supposed to be there with his wife and fellow U.S. Army officer, Christy, for the birth. He had his leave already scheduled ahead of time. Instead, Anthony died trying to make his new son's world a little bit safer. Young Marcus is just 3 now, and I hear that he's a true chip off the old block. One of the reasons I'm telling you Anthony's story tonight is I want to make sure his son Marcus grows up knowing and truly understanding exactly how much his father meant to those who loved him. And to all those countless Americans and Iraqis that he laid down his life for in combat. Tony's tragic and untimely death always reminds me of another captain's remarks. The captain's words are a tribute to all servicemen everywhere, most especially those lost in the line of duty. Captain Karen Dorman Kimmel once said, "Without a word, this uniform also whispers of freezing troops, injured bodies, and Americans left forever in foreign fields. It documents every serviceman's courage who, by accepting this uniform, promises the one gift he truly has to give, his life. I wear my uniform for the heritage of sacrifice it represents and more. I wear my uniform with pride, for it represents the greatest nation of free people in the world. Tonight, we remember a young man who very much loved boxing in the uniform of his country. Tony Palermo was on my boxing team at Norwich University. He was a tough kid. He never complained to me about the crazy workouts I put together for practice each day. And he was always quick with a smile when he didn't have to be intense. Tony was from Brockton, the same town that produced Marvin Hagler and Rocky Marciano. And his accent always reminded me of home and Boston. When I talked to his junior ROTC commander at Brockton High School, Colonel Tripp, he told me Tony had just about every leadership role and responsibility a guy could have in his program. He was a born leader. Unfortunately, I never did get to see Tony develop into the true soldier and devoted Army officer he became. He was a few years behind me at Norwich, but he was no less hard to forget. When I heard the news of Tony's death, all that I could think about was how fast he rose to the rank of captain, and how when I knew him, he was just a bright-eyed kid with a good jab and enthusiasm for the sport of boxing. He never stopped wanting to learn more. Just like he practiced and mastered the basic punches and movements I taught him, he absorbed everything he was taught quickly in the Army and he was said to be utterly devoted to the men under his command. I have no doubt that the 4 years Anthony Palermo spent as an officer in the Army were years in which he provided the men under his command with the kind of leadership he would want himself. His devotion to duty was second to none, and his love for his family and country can't even really be quantified in the little time we have here tonight. Suffice it to say, over there, you'll see Tony Palermo's plaque, which we hope to place at Brockton High School. And this will forever remind future generations of what it means to make the ultimate sacrifice and what it really means to be a true American hero. We will be raising money for the plaque through a website I created at anthonypalermomemorial.info. We'd like to have the plaque placed by the end of this year, and there'll be further announcements as they happen on the site. Right now, I'd like to personally thank Norwich University for pulling out all the stops to help promote this tribute. They were instrumental in reaching out to Anthony's classmates. President Richard Schneider of Norwich University personally donated $100 to the Black Project. Tony's fellow combat veterans and classmates, Ray Murray, Brent Eisenbach, and Steve Gagner were among the first to donate. And my sincere thanks to the university for stepping up like that in honor of a true hero. Sheila Abbott is here tonight representing the Norwich Board of Fellows. Stand up, Sheila, wherever you are. One of the reasons I did this tonight, folks, is not just for this one night. This is going to be forever. And one of the people that's helped making that happen is Steve Martin. He's here in the audience tonight with BePositiveProject.com. That's the letter B. And he's going to be working with us in the fund to keep it going. To conclude this segment of the tribute, I'd really appreciate it right now if everybody...